engineering through the years built dies to run in conventional mechanical presses, as well as fast-acting air presses. In recent years, many of our customers requested that we provide another alternative to make better use of today's sophisticated electronic controls. New high-speed hydraulic technology was the answer. We now design and build our own custom hydraulic systems with full integrated electronic controls to fit a wide range of applications. We, of course, still work with mechanical and air presses. This gives us total flexibility when designing systems to best suit your needs. Our first example shows the fast cycle capability of hydraulics. This particular example shows the high speed cutting of 5-inch long steel parts at 50 feet per minute, holding a tolerance of plus or minus 15 thousandths. The net result is 120 parts per minute. The measuring is accomplished by a rotary encoder reading directly off of the strip on an open loop basis. This next line is producing a steel office partition product complete with rectangular knockouts for electrical access. In this line, Hill Engineering furnished a hydraulic pre-punching system, which will be shown in detail in the example that follows this one. We also supplied a rotary encoder and a hydraulic post-punch and cutoff system consisting of 4 post-punching dies to produce the knockouts and a hydraulic flying cutoff die. Notice the universally adjustable rail assemblies, which give us total flexibility for aligning the dies to the piece part as it comes out of the roll former. This line operates at 45 feet per minute, holding a tolerance of plus or minus 20 thousandths from knockout to knockout and overall length. The line incorporates an electronic controller which sequences all 5 dies to generate the proper punching and cutoff pattern. As you can see here, there are no punched openings to pile it into, due to the knockout being pressed back into the piece part. We are therefore relying on the electronic measuring system to accurately track the knockout positions and fire the cutoff in relationship to them. Now we take a look at the same basic roll forming line setup to run a different product. This illustrates the quick change versatility of hydraulic press die systems. As you can see, the post-punching press dies have been shifted to storage shelves just behind their die carriages. We have pre-punched side notches and slots into the part and now pilot into these side notches for locating the cutoff. We incorporated a unique double-acting pilot unit, which upon seeing the side notches, fires an air booster, and upon re-engaging the notch, fires the cutoff press die. This unique system engages the lead end of the notch, which puts the part under tension to eliminate any possibility of part buckling upon pilot impact. Looking at the hydraulic pre-punch system, we see an electro-servo pinch roll feeder, feeding a pre-programmed sequence through the hydraulic press dies. These dies are fired at the proper sequence by the feed controller. The beauty of the two separate press dies is that they can be individually punched on any given feed to create any pattern desired. The dies are set up for quick change. By unscrewing four bolts on each die, the dies can be pulled out toward the operator. The hydraulic cylinders are attached to the dies using a slide-in bracket requiring no bolts. These systems are very quiet in their operation. Here is an example of a self-contained pneumatic press die unit which cuts off 3/16 to 5/16 of an inch steel tubing, taking a slug at 600 feet per minute. The air cylinder concept was used here for two main reasons. First, extremely high speeds require extremely fast presses, and air presses are faster than hydraulic presses. And secondly, low tonnage allowed us to drop back to an air press concept. We are utilizing a closed loop accelerator measuring system, which operates with a rotary encoder and controller to electronically track the tubing, accelerate the die to match the tubing's speed, and fire the cutoff end. We are holding a length tolerance here of plus or minus 1/4 inch at the 600 feet per minute.